A properly set up CRM should help your sales team work more efficiently. In HubSpot, the lead status property is essential in accomplishing that goal.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
A lot of people get confused about two of HubSpot's default fields, the lifecycle stage field and the lead status field. But today, we're going to clear up that confusion. The easiest way to tell the two apart is to think of the lifecycle stage field as one that you use for all of the contacts in your CRM. And for the lead status field, it's one used primarily by your sales team for the contacts that they're pursuing. So today we're going to dive into lead status in a little bit more detail. So let's hop right in here. So to get to the settings for lead status, you're going to click on the gear icon and go to properties. And you can locate it in the list or you can search for it. So lead status, as I mentioned, is a default field. So it's gonna be in your CRM as soon as you get it, and it's already going to have some labels already in here. So the default ones that it has are new, open, in progress, open deal, unqualified, attempted to contact, connected, and bad timing. So you can see that these are helpful, but you may want to adjust them to match your sales cycle. But most importantly, as I mentioned earlier, they're used by the sales team. So for new leads in your system, subscribers, people who you're not pursuing as a potential customer for your product, you will probably never need to use lead status for those contacts. For new people who might be MQLs moving on to SQL, or for people that are going through an opportunity pipeline, that's when these are really helpful. And they help your sales team kind of prioritize who they're reaching out to, when they're reaching out to them, and what level of success they've had as they've reached out to them. So for example, for a brand new MQL that a salesperson hasn't reached out to, they might get assigned to them as new. Once the salesperson has reviewed it, they might set it to open. Once they've started to reach out to them, they might label it in progress and so forth. But as I mentioned earlier, these are just the default fields. And if you want to, you can customize these to match your sales cycle better. I highly encourage you to involve your whole sales team in this process to see what properties they might like to have, because you want to make sure that this matches their process really well so that they actually use it. But to edit it, you can click on any of these to edit them. You can always add an option. You can click and drag to reorder them. But for right now, we are just going to leave the default ones. And I'm going to show you a way that you can use these a little bit more effectively than just having your sales team kind of edit them as you go. So we're going to dig into a workflow that you could use as one example to kind of take your lead status and make it a little bit more powerful for you. So what we're going to do is we're gonna make it so that anytime a new MQL is created, so maybe that's created through lead scoring where a contact takes enough activity that they get labeled as an MQL, or maybe your marketing team labels them manually, doesn't really matter. We're gonna set up a workflow so that anytime you have a new MQL, they get labeled as new here. So we're gonna jump over to the workflows tool. And this is going to be a really simple workflow, but you can do the same kind of workflow to update the lead status every time a deal is created, update the lead status once a deal is closed won or closed lost, and so forth. You can kind of get pretty creative here. So we're going to hit start from scratch on this workflow, and it's going to be a contact-based workflow, so we're going to create it. And the trigger is just going to be that the contact property of lifecycle stage is set to MQL. So marketing qualified lead, and apply that filter, hit save. So now any contact who becomes a marketing qualified lead will be entered into this workflow. And then we want to make sure that their lead status is set to new. Search for lead status here and select new. And save that. So for our purposes, this is really all you need to do for the workflow. Anytime a new marketing qualified lead is created, it gets set to new. You could also do some things if you wanted to, like assign this to a specific sales rep or rotate between sales reps using this rotate leads one. You could create a deal in here if you wanted to, but for our cases, we're just gonna have it be really simple. New marketing qualified lead makes it so their lead status is new.
So that's all there is for lead status. If you have any questions about this video or you wanna see us cover something else in a future hack, go ahead and drop in those comments below. And as always, hit that subscribe button for more HubSpot hacks, tips, and how-tos.